Hello commanders and welcome to this video for Infinite Lagrange. Today is the start of the game in US, Canada, Australia and quite a few other countries, and also we do have a new server. If you click on the server you can always see what date they started. So as you see, the last server was opened 28, and right today we got two new servers opening. Era 101, and also we do have Canis Minor. So if you're new to the game, probably maybe from the US, Canada, Australia or one of the other countries that just started today, you can choose one of these. I do like Era more for a name, so I will choose this to enter the game. And I will try to give you an overview in this video of the first steps, what you have to do in the game, and how to progress fast, where you have to put your focus on, and so on and so on. So I'll just skip the intro and be back in a second with the game. Okay, so the first thing you have to do in the game is choose where you start. And you can change this later, so that's possible. But it does have a big impact, as you can only join alliances or unions that are in the same region as you are. So I will just, it was selected on region 4, I'll just go to region 5, I don't like number 4, and then my base will appear somewhere here. I can't really choose anything there. Good, so I skipped the intro sequence again, and the first time, like in many games, you have no other option than to follow the tutorial. So we'll be back as soon as I'm done with that. Okay, so the tutorial is over, and this will be the screen you are left in. Very likely you will click next on your missions, and you do see especially the main missions, which are always a good indicator what you should do next. So if you didn't do it, I recommend you go to research and continue your research. There are two ships you can research. One is the FG-300 and the 3 up here. And all these ships will be the same for every player. You will have to get all of them, so don't worry about this. Every time you come to one of these ships, it takes you some time to do the research. And these small nodes, they are instant. As said, you will use the frigate for some time at the beginning. I would recommend start with this. And you do have a second branch here, where you can put your next research chest inside. And we'll also do this directly. Sorry, I forgot to turn on the light. We'll do this directly and continue researching here. Same thing, research points are given you instantly. As soon as you get 15 research points, you do get a chest that will give you a guaranteed ship blueprint. When you get these tech points, you can choose to which ship you want to give them. At the beginning, there's not so much choice you have. Okay, what else do we have here? We do have the Dawn funding scheme. So if you're free to play, you will have the upper ones. If you want to spend a little bit of money, I would recommend you to sign up for the strategic partnership agreement. It is around $15 and you do get quite a lot for that. To get points, all you have to do is be a little bit active. Every action point you use will give you 10 points, and every kill will give you 1 point per week. So you will get all these, and at the end you do get a battle cruiser, which is one of the biggest ships you can have at the moment. So Dawn financial plan is the next thing you should go for. Save 1000 Proxima coins and buy this. So the Proxima coins are in-game currency, and as soon as you get 1000 of them, you do get 100 Proxima coins every day back for 1 month for 30 days, and the last day you get 200 back. So a total you get 3,200 for an investment of 1,000. Absolutely worth it. In the store you will find these packages, and now that's a problem, they also cost Proxima coins. So you will have to think when and what to buy. Would recommend you always to buy every day the 50% discounted box on the right side for 150. And when you do have a lot of Proxima coins, the ships inside this one, you can always check what's inside the box by clicking on the symbol. So you do have the chance to get frigates or destroyers, and if you click on the eye up here, it tells you 50-50. So a 50% chance to get the Wing to Tsar, and a 50% chance to get either the Reliant or the Mare Tranquillitas. The Wing to Tsar is a great ship. The other two are okay, but you won't use them very long. If you do have enough Proxima coins, you already did the Dawn funding scheme, then you should get this too. But yeah, one after the other. Let's take a look at our base, because this will be the most important thing for you at the beginning. When we go to construction, we can see all the buildings we can build. And on the right side here, we do have this arrow. And when we click there, we see there are multiple levels we can expand to. And you want to expand as fast as possible. In special, you want to be able to go to level 4 for the outpost command center. This is very important at the beginning to get. And when you click on expand, it will tell you what you need to build. We need capital shipyard on level 4, generic port on level 3, and warehouse on level 4. So these are now our most important things we are going to focus on. And we can also see this with these small bars here. So we're going to upgrade our generic port, the warehouse also, but let's continue first with the capital shipyard. It will show you also which kind of bonuses you get when you do this. You can speed these things up. You do have the speed ups. Every speed up gives you a 5 minute speed up. And when we go outside here, let's go quickly in the normal base view. Under resource management, you will see that you do get 2 speed ups per hour. So every hour you do get a total of 10 minute speed ups. There's a maximum of 60 speed ups that you can store. As soon as it is full, you stop generating new speed ups here on the left side. So don't feel afraid to use these. As said, they do automatically recover, and especially overnight you will always get quite a few of these back. And just try to upgrade all these things that you need. If you do this following my advice, you will see that you will be quite ahead of the other players very quick. Now we don't need to waste one for only 2 seconds. So we use them again here for the 5 minute ones. And there we go. And very, very quick we will be able already to go. Right now, we are now able to expand to zone 2. And this will take 40 minutes and it cannot be speed up. While we do this, you can already, if you want to, upgrade your generic port. We don't need to speed it up, but the generic port does also give us industrial port command points. And later we do need these for additional ships, so as soon as this would go up, it would be great. Okay, so shipbuilding, that will be the next thing. We already started it. Here on the top you can see we do have 25 military port command points. We use 12 of them, and we do have 20 resource command points, and we use 10. So the most important thing right now is to build one more of these mining ships, because we will need the resources later to be able to upgrade more of our buildings. And same here, we can speed up. We do use a different kind of module, so that's great. We do have these modules too. And if we take a look at the resource management, you see that these modules, they both get more in parallel. So you can use both of them, and for both of them you do also have limits. Other ships we can build at the moment is only the FG-300, which I won't do right now. Very quickly we will get other ships. And besides that, we will see that we continue doing our missions, because we do get a lot of resources, especially at the beginning. And there also we now see we have to build two more frigates. So we will just build one, two. We can put them in a queue and they will continue building. We could now speed this up, but there's no need, because we will be locked anyhow then at this point. We do try to increase our blueprint experience by combat. For this we could use the frigate, so you can speed this up. As said, we do have anyhow enough speed ups, and then you can start. Let's get even more. We still do have a few common points, so let's just get the maximum, that we do have the biggest army we can get. And then we can create a fleet. In this case we select all our ships. We can give the fleet also a name. Attack fleet, for example. Confirm it, create it. And then we can go out and attack these pirates that were mentioned before. For this you need operation zones. So first thing I now do is I cancel the operation zones that I built before, because we only have a limited number of operation zones. And when we going to set up a new one, you can already see here it has a certain range. So I'm going to set up this operation zone here, confirm it, and then I click on this enemy and attack it with my fleet. And you will see this costs us action points. You can set auto return if you want your fleet to automatically return after the fight. We don't want this at the moment. We do have an advantage, so we will very likely win. So we will send out the fleet to the enemy. It needs only 2 minutes to be there. If we click here on top, we do see the action points we have. 120 of total of 150. If we click on the eye, we do get some information about what cost how many action points. We will go into these things later in detail. So now we already know how to gather resources. So we do mine here. We cannot send another miner to the same position, but we will need more resources later. So we do have a metal zone very close here and here, and we can send our miner that we did build there if we have another operation zone. So we build our operation zone, we go to rapid formation, there's our mining ship, or you can select it from the formation. You create the fleet and you do send it out. So you will see we get at the moment 5737 metal per hour, 143 crystal, 38 deuterium. As soon as this fleet arrives here and starts to gather resources, we will get more metal every hour. And that is the first things you should look to. You can check your results from the fights here on the bottom left, and you can see these reports. You can read messages like the system message. You can join the Discord there. One other important thing, especially if you do have a lot of players around you, you very likely want to join an alliance. A union is here on the bottom right, the symbol, and you can either join a union. As said, you can only join unions that are inside your area. We do have a Russian union here already in region 3 on the server. We do have an all language one in region 4. We did start in 5. So what I'm going to do is I will just create a happy union, and I can set up some preferences. We will be all languages. If anyone want to join, I don't require approval. And I would need to pay 200 Proxima coins to do this. At the moment, I don't have these. So, if you want to get them, there are two options. Either you spend money or you do wait till you get them from the Dawn funding scheme. And as said before, for every action point you do spend, you do get these points, more, yeah, these points for the Dawn funding plan, and then you can get additional boxes for research, and you do also get Proxima coins that you can use for all this stuff. Okay, so I think that was a very quick overview about the most important things to do to follow, and we did kill one here. We will just attack the next one over here. As we are in the same circle, we only have to pay 10 action points. Another option you can do is to use a blockade mode, especially if you have multiple fleets there. The blockade mode will. Oh, we don't have blockade yet. We first have to research this, we have to build the building. Later, when you can do blockade, that will attack all enemies inside your operation zone. So for now, we still have to manually attack them one by one. Just continue doing this. You will also, at the same time, continue doing your main missions step by step and progress then very, very quickly. Don't forget, after only 40 minutes, you are already inside the next base expansion, and you can continue looking what is required to go into zone 3, because as said before, we want to get into zone 4 and get the outpost command center as fast as possible. And we cannot speed this up. So I will stop the video now here, and I will upload another video for the next steps on in the game as soon as possible. As soon as I get to zone 4, you will get another update with things and also more advanced tips and tricks how to get further in the game. Hope you liked the video. Give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and then I see you all on the next video again.